And so, the Sea Tactics is here again, talking about one of his favorite animes of spring 2019. And somehow, it's Why the Hell Are You Here, Teacher? That's right, in a season with One Punch Man, Kimetsu no Yaiba, and Carolyn Tuesday, not to mention the continuing anime from winter 2019, this is somehow one of my favorites in the spring 2019 season. So with that being said, just let me introduce you to this anime. Sato is a very unlucky dude. He is your regular 17-year-old who is focused on studying and getting good grades, but he is unlucky in the sense that at inopportune times, he finds himself stuck with his teacher, the demon, Kana Kojima, in weird situations. Kana is a young teacher in her 20s who has earned the nickname of the demon by being fierce and hard on her students and colleagues, expecting only the best from them. But Sato may not be unlucky after all, as frequently he gets closer and closer to his teacher in more ways than one. This is Why the Hell Are You Here, Teacher? This anime... Look, I'm sorry, but I love this anime, and the fact it's able to easily entertain me may be a sign that I've fallen from grace. And as a proud anime YouTuber, or as the kids call us, AnyTubers, yes, I still hate that name, you are judged on your ability to break down anime like Fate Zero or Gundam and bring your viewers intellectual content and also use that weird stock paper background animations and say really pretentious things like the war. But today, I descend into the madness of trash anime, so I'm calling you out, Chibi Reviews, SAO. I'm calling you out too, Saber says. Today, Sea Tactics talks about why the hell are you here, teacher? And today is the day that I truly ascend to trash anime review heaven. Why the Hell Are You Here, Teacher? Is an anime I enjoy because of the simple fact that it's self-aware. It knows you aren't watching for the plot, rather you're watching for the plot. And I don't mean plot as in, for example, Fate Zero, the battle of ideologies, and how many Saber points you can get to bang Saber. No, I am talking about plot as in T and A, not TNA. That's a different thing. The stuff that anime fans just can't get enough of. The stuff that might as well be a currency. I'd like a milkshake, and I'll pay you in waifus. That's right, call your dentist, tell him he's a little bitch, because we're dining on anime babes tonight. And while cannibalism in that sense of the word isn't illegal, it also isn't illegal to enjoy this masterpiece of an anime. Have you ever thought about walking in on your hot teacher in the men's bathroom? Because the women's bathroom was full, and that was the only place that she can get a little privacy? No, I'm sure you haven't, because we, as far as I'm aware, aren't that weird. Have you ever then motorboated your teacher and then by accident pissed on her? Chances are you've never even thought about this once in your life. But let me tell you something, this anime has. It's done that for you because now you don't have to think about it. You can just sit down and watch it. You can experience this truly holy experience. And while you think I possibly just had a stroke, no, I didn't have one. Because this anime would cure strokes if it could. I don't know if you can cure those, and I just made that up on the spot, but seriously, look at Kojima. She'd cure any of my variety of diseases I have accrued over the millennia. That's right, I'm immortal, bitch. And while I may not be immortal, I have realized I haven't really talked about this anime that much. So, what I love about so much about it is that the relationships between the multiple couples is actually quite decent. For example, while they all start out underage, not the teachers, the students, the relationships progress in such a way that the teachers never actually break any laws. Technically. Now, there is that one time Sato is forced to give Kojima a suppository, and he kinda misses the mark the first time, but she was just in need of a helping hand. So, you know, it's not like illegal, and I like that a lot. They only ever bang after they graduate and turn of age, and makes it not weird besides those parts where it is weird, which is the whole point of this anime. What am I saying? The art for this anime is also pretty impressive. I'm actually being serious about that. It's not the best art I've ever seen, but for an anime of this stature, it's not bad. Like, at all. As you can see, there are some punchlines to the jokes that look pretty good. Like, with Kojima holding a chainsaw here. That looks cool. And if you're wondering what they did with the nudity, well, they censored the show by putting little chibi versions of the characters over the peepees and hoo-haws. This, to me, is better than full-on nudity because it adds to the comedy of the show and how ridiculous the concept is. Sadly, though, because of this, I won't be able to rate the nipple graphics like I was in my manga review. Now that I think about it, I'm not even sure if I did that in my review for the manga. But hey, revisionist history doesn't matter when you're this far into a shitty joke. Listen, if you're not watching this anime, there is something wrong with you. And while you may think there is something wrong with me for watching this anime, you are wrong. You are all wrong. Because I am right about this. Just look at Kana Kojima. I can't be wrong. And if you think I'm wrong, you're still wrong. So don't be wrong and watch this anime so that you can correct yourself and remember to watch this anime. If you don't watch this anime and enjoy it, I'm seriously going to cry. So don't make me cry, and don't be wrong about this show. Watch it. It's on High Dive, okay? And Verve as well, since Verve is on High Dive. And if you don't have those, it's also airing on Crunchyroll with a 1 week delay. Just look at her. You just can't say no to her. So that being said, I hope you enjoyed that weird video. That just all came out at once. If you want to, you can support me on Patreon. That would be cool. You can throw a dollar my way and you get access to a bunch of cool things. Got a lot of awesome things planned for Patreon in the future. And, you know, you can do some other stuff like and subscribe and ring the bell. Definitely that one. I'll see you later. Bye-bye.